Graham Lee, Fide Master. John Ems, Grand Master. Julian Hodgson, Grand Master. Paul Littlewood, International Master. Desmond Tan, former England Junior. Jonathan Levitt, Grand Master. Chris Ward, Grand Master. Nathan Alfred, Fide Master. And Robert Chan, President of the Chess Society, King's College, London.
An average to good chess player normally would think about 2 or 3 moves ahead in a game. A chess grandmaster can think anything up to 20 moves ahead. In the next room, I've got 9 of the country's top chess players. Some of them are rising stars on the circuit. There's some international masters in there, and not one, but 4 world-rated grandmasters. I'm going to play chess with them all simultaneously. Using the skills that I've learned and the techniques that I've developed over the years, I'm going to go in there and absolutely lie to them. I'm hoping that the lies that I tell will give me the psychological edge to beat a few of them, and hopefully even a grandmaster. And afterwards, I'll tell you how I did it. Do bear in mind as you watch this, my chess is sheet.
Good evening, gentlemen. Thank you so much for your time. So I'm going to attempt to play 9 games of chess with you simultaneously. My chess is very good, obviously nowhere near as good as your standards, but I've spent a year planning this. And during that time, I've been reading transcripts and been trying to familiarise myself with your games. Okay, I'm going to give this... What's your name?
Graham. Graham Lee.
Graham. I'm going to ask you just to hang on to that for a second. Have you got an inside pocket you could put that in? That would be superb. And hang on to that. I'll ask you for that at the end. Terrific. Thank you. I'm going to ask you all to take a seat there. Now, your names are on the table, so please find your place. Off you go.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, guys. Just one thing also I should point out. There are no computers. I'm not linked to any supercomputer for this. And, John, there's no earpieces yet. Yeah. This is all genuinely above board. OK. Graham, good luck.
Thank you.
By the better man. I thought I was playing okay, but he just came up with some really good moves.
I could have played on at the end, but I mean, I was just a whole rook down, so I thought I'd put myself out of my misery.
Never good to lose. It's one of the worst things in chess, the worst thing. Got the opening a bit wrong, and from then on it was all downhill.
It's always nice to win. First 15 moves or so, I felt as though I was playing a leading grandmaster opponent.
I was quite surprised, yeah, by his standard. I was a bit lucky, actually, in the end, managed to draw.
It was close at the end, but I just came through with a nice combination.
Thank you very much. Will you count the number of your own pieces that are left on the board before you leave? It'll be important for later.
I drew my game. I think I made 2 small mistakes. I've been British champion 4 times, so I've sort of been one of England's top players for about the last 15 years. What he's done today is extremely impressive.
Unfortunately, I lost. You win some, you lose some. I lost this one.
Thanks.
Fantastic, well done.
I've played a grandmaster, and I think Derren is on a par with them, at least.
Thank you so much for your time and expertise today. The results of that, I guess, were I won at 4 tables, lost at 3, and then drew against the other 2, so that technically would be a win for me against you as a group, and that's beating 2 grandmasters. I'm delighted. One last thing, before you go, just wondering if this number means anything to you. 611, 7106, 118105? No. Okay, right, well, I asked you to count up the number of pieces left of your own colour on the board. So, Graham, at table number one, how many pieces were left of your own colour?
I've got 7 pieces of my own colour left.
7 pieces of your own colour. That's a mistake, then. That should be a 7. Okay, and next table?
I've got 11.
11. 1-1. Next table?
7, yep, spot on.
7.
10 pieces.
10 pieces.
6 pieces.
6.
I've got 11 pieces.
11, thank you.
That'll be 8 pieces I have left.
8, terrific.
10 pieces.
You have 10 pieces. And finally, Robert there.
I've got 5 pieces left.
You've got 5 pieces left. Excellent, thank you. So that's obviously just a memory feat, one of several memory feats that I was indulging in during that game. I gave you an envelope, sorry, at the very start. Could you, I don't want to touch it, would you just come around here for me and open it?
Certainly.
Just stand there for me, that'd be great. Take out what's inside, just give me the envelope, I'll get rid of that. Cheers, thank you very much indeed. Yeah, if you just take that there. What I hope will keep you up all night is how I was trying to influence those games desperately as I was playing to end up with precisely that result. 6, mistake, 117, 106, 118, 105. Pretty much spot on.
This has been in this pocket the whole time. You have not touched
it. I have not touched it, no. Thank you so much for your attention and your time and everything today. I really appreciate it. Graham, you can keep that from me. Thanks so
much. Thank you very much indeed.
Take care. Thank you, guys. Thank you all very much. Thank you.
For him to pull out a whole series of numbers based on 9 separate games of chess, that is astonishing. I can guarantee that envelope stayed from the moment he gave it me at the start till after the results were announced in this pocket. There was no cheating. I've not been asked to do anything by Derren. I just turned up, played chess, looked after an envelope. This game finished because it was a draw at some random point. And yet he's predicted the number of pieces left in all the games. This is going to keep me awake tonight.
Right, so here's how you play chess with a room of top chess players. First of all, mentally divide them into pairs. So with 8 players, that's 4 pairs of 2. And behind me is one of those pairs. At table number 1, we had Graham Lee, and I had him mentally paired off with Desmond Tan over at table number 5, over the other side of the room. Graham was playing white, and Desmond was playing black. Graham's opening move of the game was pawn to e4. I remembered that move, I didn't have to respond at that point, and when I got round to table number 5, Desmond's table, I merely repeated that move, pawn to e4. Desmond's response was pawn to c5. I remembered that response. And when I get back to Graham on number 1, I just mirror Desmond's move, pawn to c5. I'm not actually playing chess with either of them, I'm just remembering the moves and then mirroring them across on the other person's table. In fact, they're playing chess with each other. When playing all 9, it's a lot more complicated. So, I start at table 1 and I remember the opening. I go to 2 and remember that opening, and the same with 3 and 4. Then at 5, I play the opening from table 1 and remember the response. On 6, I play the opening from 2 and remember that response. On 7, I play 3's opening and remember that. And on 8, I do the same from table 4. We'll leave table 9 for the moment. Back to 1, and I play the response from 5 and remember this new response, and so on around the board, remembering the responses around one side of the room and playing them on the other side. That will give me an equal number of wins and loses against the group, as half will win or lose against the other half. So how then do I come out on top? Well, that's where table 9 comes in. In amongst everything else, I'm playing one real game of chess at table 9. Robert is the least strong player of the group, and as long as I beat him, the result will tip in my favour. That's how I win. As for how I predicted the number of pieces left on each board, I genuinely can't remember. Good night.